I first started 5 years ago. My high school counselor suggested to me that I talk to Melanie Flammy at the Park Service and get in with her doing the small mammal field work. And
she came in and did a presentation on the small mammal project, and I was like, oh my god, that sounds like something I would love to do. So I introduced myself to her. I've been with her ever since. So.
I started 5 years ago. I was 13. I was interested in science in general, so I decided to try out biology.
So I first started out as a volunteer, and this is my fourth year.
I'm a biology major, so it sounded like something I would definitely be interested in, so I thought I'd give it a try, and I really enjoy it.
I've gained skills in field biology, recording data, checking traps. We've also lately started to learn more about actually how the project's conducted.
I definitely learned a lot about the voles. I realized how important they are for the environment and for other species too, and how important it is to keep track of their populations.
I really like that I'm getting to apply my knowledge from the books, because I've always liked biology and I like learning about it. It's just a lot more fun to be able to experience it firsthand.
It was really interesting because I used in the genetics lab some samples we took out here, both cheek swabs and tissue samples. I hadn't gotten to see much before I started working in the lab, like what went on after the project.
There's so much of wildlife conservation and wildlife science that we can learn by spending time in the lab and doing laboratory procedures. And also, you know, you are able to follow your study through from beginning to end.
I definitely prefer the lab work, just because I like the lab environment more, and I like to be warm.
Kind of like lab work, because you don't get bitten. There's a set process that's easy to follow, but I think I like the field work more just because it's more dynamic and kind of unpredictable.
I think it's important to expose the students to that because, you know, really, whether you're looking at contaminants or DNA to determine the extent of the population, there's just so much that can be done in the lab that it's clearly part of wildlife science. So with this next generation of scientists, we want to make sure that they're aware of all the questions that can be answered by spending time in the basement, in addition to spending time outside.
When I first started, I knew nothing about camping. I was 18 and like just graduated high school. In my first year, I came out with like half-sized little kid rain boots and no rain pants and just like really unprepared. Now I can pack my own bear barrel, I can shop for myself. Not only grew as in like more experienced camping, but I just know a lot more about field work and biology now too.
The first year we came out with like all cotton base layers and didn't really know how to prepare for the weather when we were out on trap checks. And it's fun to see them now being so competent and learning the new skills like tagging and wrangling. And I think we've all gotten a lot better with that.
Definitely became more mature. I grew up kind of doing it because I started when I was 15 and now I'm turning 19. I guess it really helped me build character.
You know, when it comes to Tristan and I, we grew up in the woods with our dad. We were doing everything. Seeing him come and go back and forth from the Park Service, I'd say has really contributed vastly to him growing up.
One of my favorite highlights is always holding baby voles.
Little babies are really cute.
They're extremely adorable.
They're just so cute.
We're actually holding them in our hands. It's real. It's right in front of us.
Do you guys think you've made good friends on the small mammal project?
Absolutely.
I really like the people. Everyone has great personalities.
As you probably guessed, we have a lot of fun at camp.
It doesn't really seem like it's been only a few weeks. It seems like I've known them for quite a while.
I think my favorite thing about it is kind of the camaraderie, and especially by the end of the week when we're all tired and probably a little bit sleep deprived, we kind of become one large family every year.
My favorite part is the opportunity for people both new and experienced to get out here and do field work and get a hands-on experience with people who know what they're doing, who can help them. But I definitely feel like people have grown in their getting to sit more comfortably into their roles on the project, even advancing into higher roles.
I think I've gotten a lot better at leading groups.
With this project in particular, I've done it enough years now that I feel like I can kind of take on a leadership role. Before, I just wasn't familiar enough with the process and what we do on trap checks and how we set things up to really feel like I could direct other people in doing that.
And it's led to like other opportunities as well. I've worked on other projects for the Park Service, starting as a volunteer on this project.
We have our, we call it the Fab Four, the four of us that all started at the same time. We're all kind of leaders on this trip, and we all guide everybody else in when we're there wrangling the voles.
One of my favorite parts is definitely getting to work in Denali. It's a really beautiful area, and I love coming down here every year.
I don't know, it made me really like being outside, and it made me appreciate a lot more the things that Alaska has to offer.
I love camping and that kind of thing, but I don't get to do it that often, so I'm really happy to be out here.
I like feeling like I'm contributing to the world.
It's the best part.
Rolling.